solve a homogeneous differential equation x squared y double prime minus x minus 2 ninth times y is equal to 0. So first let's find p of x and q of x. So p of x is equal to 0 because you don't have y prime here. Q of x is equal to negative x minus 2 ninth over x squared. So we have a problem when x equals 0 here. So x equals 0 is a singular point. Then we're going to take x times q of x, which is 0, and x squared times q of x, which is negative of x minus 2 ninth. Then x equals 0 is a regular singular point. Then our final solution is given in this form. Y is equal to the power series from 0 to infinity, cn x to the n plus r times, and that's it. Take the first derivative, gives me power series from 0 to infinity, cn n plus r, x to the n plus r minus 1. So you bring down the exponent and then subtract the exponent by 1. Take the second derivative, gives me power series from 0 to infinity, cn n plus r minus 1, x to the n plus r minus 2. So again, bring down the exponent and then subtract the exponent by 1. Now what I'm going to do next is to plug these into this differential equation, but before I do that, I am going to distribute this out. Then I have x squared y prime minus xy plus 2 over 9 times y is equal to 0. Right, now let's plug these in. Plug these into this one. So I have power series from 0 to infinity. Cn n plus r times n plus r minus 1 times x to the n plus r. So you have x squared times x to the n plus r minus 2, so 2 minus 2 is 0. Okay, minus power series from 0 to infinity. Cn n, just cn. Okay, because you have x and y, so times this one, so cn x to the n plus r plus 1 plus power series from 0 to infinity 2 over 9 cn x to the n plus r is equal to 0, right? Now we are going to take a look at the induction power. So x equals 0, n equals 0, x to the r, n equals 0, x to the r plus 1, n equals 0, x to the r. So we are going to run out times of these two power series because this one we have x to the r plus 1. So run out times of this one first, running 0 I have c naught times r times r minus 1 x to the r, okay, plus power series from 1 to infinity cn n plus r n plus r minus 1 times x to the n plus r. So for this one we're going to rewrite it, but if I were about to run out time for this one, I would get n equal, I would have n starts at 1. So it makes sense to index this during this step, okay, to save time. If you couldn't see this first, you would rewrite it, and then later on, yeah, you would reinvest it, and it just takes your time, okay? So, reinvest this to 1, I have cn minus 1, so add 1, so I have to subtract 1, x to the n plus r, and then run out time for this one, so I have 2 ninth c naught x to the r, plus power series from 1 to infinity, 2 over 9 cn x to the n plus r is equal to 0. Now we are going to combine like terms, so let's take a look at the x to the r, and x to the r. So I have our c naught in common as well. Okay? So factor our c naught. Then I have distribute this out, r squared minus r plus 2 over 9 times x to the r. Now for this one, we're gonna factor out x to the r n plus r. And of course equals 0. So let's take a look. So we have cn, so factor it out. Then we have cn. And if I say I have n plus r minus 1, plus 2 9, minus cn minus 1. Okay? Now we are going to equate coefficient. So you have c naught times r squared minus r plus 2 over 9 is equal to 0. And cn n plus r minus 1 plus 2 over 9 minus cn minus 1 is equal to 0. So this is my system of equations, sorry. So this is my system of equations. Now, for this one, I'm going to rewrite, solve for r, but I'm going to rewrite this in terms of factor, in factor form. So, first I'm going to get rid of the fraction here, so I'm going to multiply both sides by 9. Then I have c naught, 9r squared minus 9r plus 2 is equal to 0. Now I'm going to rewrite this in factor form. So, we'll use the lemma method. So two numbers add up to negative 9 and their product is 18. So we have negative 6 and negative 3. So I have c naught over, don't forget to divide by the least coefficient, which is 9. So I have c naught. And this one I have r minus 2 thirds. Simplify this. On this side I have r minus 1 third is equal to 0. Now solve for r. If r equals 2 thirds and 1 third. So I didn't solve for c naught because if I solve for c naught, then at the final solution, unless you not times something and c not is zero, then it's just nothing, okay? Now we can solve for r equals 2/3 and r equals 1/3, so each of the r value will give us one solution for y. So let's take a look at the case when r equals 2/3. So plugging 2/3 into this one, I have c in plus 2/3 times in, so 2/3 minus 1, which is negative 1/3, plus 2 over 9 minus c in minus 1 is equal to 0. Then solve for c in, I have c in minus 1 over in plus 2/3 times in minus 1/3 plus 2 over 9. So in order to get rid of the fraction here, I'm going to multiply that bottom by 9, okay? So I have 9 c in minus 1 over 3 in plus 2, 3 in minus 1 plus 2, and n is starting from 1 to 3, okay? Now when n equals 1, I have, let me write into this one, yeah, this one, I have c1 is equal to 9 c naught over, let me do math here, so 3 plus 2 is 5, 3 minus 1 is 2, 5, 2, 10, 12, hopefully I get my math right. When n equals 2, I have c2 is equal to 9 c1 over 2 times 2, 2 times 3 is 6, 6 plus 2 is 8, 2 times 3 is 6, 6 minus 1 is 5, 8 times 5 is 42. And what is c1? C1 is 9 over 12 c0, so I have 9 square c0 over 42 times 12. Okay, I'm gonna leave it like this. And then my y1 is equal to x to the r, c0 plus c1x plus c2x squared plus that, that. What is x, what is r, is 2/3, then c0 plus c1, c1 is 9 over 12x c0, then c2 is 9 squared over 42 times 12 c0 x squared plus that, that. Factor out c0 to have, oops, c0 times x to the 2/3 times 1 plus 9 over 12x plus 81 over 504 x squared plus that, that. Okay? So for this one, I can simplify it down to 3/4. And this one, I can simplify it down to 9 over 56. Right? Now let's take a look at the case when r equals 1/3. So r equals 1/3. So plugging 1/3 into this one, so I have c in plus 1 over 3 times in, so 1/3 minus 1, which gives me negative 2/3, plus 2 over 9 minus c in minus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, then I'm gonna solve for c in. Then I have c in minus 1. And then with this one, let me get oversized. So I have n minus 1, c n, minus 1 divided by n plus 1/3 times n minus 2/3 plus 2 over 9. Multiply top bottom by 9. So I have 3n plus 1, 3n minus 2 plus 2. And of course, n is starting from 1 to infinity. So when n equals 1, let 1 in, I have c1 equals 9 c0 over 1, 3 plus 1 is 4 plus 2 is 6. So let me simplify this, I have 3 c0 over 2, okay? So when n equals 2, I have c2 is equal to 9 c1 over 3 times 2 is 6, 6 plus 3 times 2 is 6, 6 plus 1 is 7, 7. 3 times 2 is 6, 6 minus 2 is 4, 7 times 4 is 28, 28 times 28 plus 2 is 30. So simplify this, I have 3 tenths times c1, which is 3 c0 over 2. Then I have 9 c0 over 20. Okay, now I'm gonna write my y2. So y2 is equal to actually r c naught plus c1x plus c2x squared plus that dot. What is r? R is actually 1 third c naught. We don't know. Just write it with c1. C1 is 3 c naught over 2 times x. But c2 is 0 is 9 c naught over 20 x squared plus that dot. Back to c naught. Then I have x to the 1 third 1 plus 3 half x plus 9 over 20 x squared plus that dot. Okay. Now my final solution is equal to y1 plus y2. Okay. And where is my y1? My y1 is this. And keep in mind that this enough and this enough are not the same. So for the first one, we write my y1, which is c naught x to the 2 third times 1 plus 3 fourth x plus 9 over 56 x squared plus dot 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 plus. So for this c naught, I'm going to call it c1 x to the 1 third 1 plus 3 half x plus 9 over 20 x squared plus dot dot dot. Right? So this is your final solution. That's it.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.